Hello students, this is Dr. Nirmalangshi here. So now we are at the end of our chapter States of Matter. So we have seen that gases obey these gas laws, and also we have derived kinetic gas equation, and also we have derived ideal gas equation, and we have seen that all gases or jitna bhi gases hai wo sab gases kya karta hai with this obey these different gas laws. These gases obey different gas laws as well as the ideal gas equation, that is PB equal to nRT. ठीक है ना? तो सब गैस जितना भी गैसेस है, सभी गैसेस क्या दिस ओबे ऑल द डिफरेंट गैस लॉज एंड आल्सो दैट इज आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन व्हिच इज पीबी इक्वल टू एनआरटी. नाउ द गैसेस व्हिच ओबे दिस गैस इक्वेशन दैट इज पीबी इक्वल टू एनआरटी, दोस गैसेस आर कॉल्ड आइडियल गैसेस. सो द गैसेस व्हिच ओबे दिस इक्वेशन पीबी इक्वल टू एनआरटी, दोस गैसेस आर कॉल्ड ideal gases. Okay, but in actually it doesn't occur. But actually it doesn't occur. The gases obey this equation only at low pressure and high temperature. The gases obey this equation at low pressure and high temperature. Okay, now at high temperature. Okay, now but when if we just reverse the condition, if we increase the pressure, if we take the gas at high pressure and if we decrease the temperature, the gases is seen that they do not obey this ideal gas equation. They do not obey this ideal gas equation. Okay, so those gases which do not obey this ideal gas equation, those gases are called real gases. Okay, those gases are called real gases. Means at high pressure and low temperature, gases do not obey gas laws, and also these ideal gas equation PB equal to nRT. So those gases are called real gases. Okay, means the gases deviate from the ideal behavior. ऐसा जा रहा है ideal behavior, ऐसा है. Suppose if it is ideal behavior, the gases deviate from the ideal behavior. Okay, so many scientists study that those deviations. Many scientists like Amagat, Andrews, they have studied these deviations. Okay, so now we are going to study the study of deviations. Okay, so many scientists like Amagat, Andrews, and many other scientists, they have come across and studied the behavior of different gases under varying conditions of temperature and pressure. क्या होता है? बहुत सारे साइंटिस्ट है जो आया इस लाइन में, इस फील्ड में आया, आने के बाद दे हैव स्टडीड द बिहेवियर ऑफ दिस गैसेस अंडर वेरिंग कंडीशन ऑफ टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर. ओके, सो दे हैव फर्स्ट स्टडीड द डेविएशंस with respect to pressure, deviations with respect to pressure. Okay, so they have plot this curve. You are very well acquainted with this curve. You know this curve very well. That is the pressure. If there is pressure on the y-axis and volume on the x-axis. So volume increase करने से pressure क्या होगा? Decrease करेगा, and that is a law which is Boyle's law. Okay, that we have studied already. So that is Boyle's law, that is V proportional to 1/P. So volume जैसे जैसे increase करेगा, वैसे वैसे pressure decrease करेगा. So the gases, it is seen that the curve is somewhat like this. Okay, the curve is somewhat like this. Now, and they have studied this behavior by plotting this curve, pressure versus volume at given temperature. Now, the curve क्या होता है real gases के लिए? This curve should coincide with the ideal gas curve. Okay, So gases which do deviate from the ideal behavior, that is which do not obey ideal gas equation PV equals nRT, for those gases this curve doesn't coincide with this curve. It should coincide, but it is not coinciding. Okay. So as the pressure is going to increase, the curve seems to be like this. Okay. It is not obeying the ideal gas equation. It is not obeying the ideal gas equation, also not obeying this Boyle's law. Means it is deviating from this behavior. Okay. So if this is the curve for real gas, this is the curve for ideal gas, okay, and this is the curve for real gas. So at high pressure the curve is not coinciding with that of ideal gas curve. Okay. So but at low pressure, these are coinciding, and these two volumes almost coincide. At low pressure, these two volumes almost coincide. Okay. So this extent of deviation, जो कि real gas दिखाता है from ideal gas behavior at different pressures, it can be explained or followed in terms of a factor known as compressibility factor. Okay, compressibility factor, that is given by Z is equal to PV by nRT for n mole and Z is equal to PV by RT for 1 mole. Okay. Now, this Z for ideal gas, this Z is equal to 1. For ideal gas, this Z is equal to 1. Okay. So, लेकिन non-ideal gas के लिए, real gas के लिए क्या होगा? Z not equal to 1. Okay. So real gas के लिए क्या होगा? Z is not equal to 1. So चलो देखते क्या होता है. For ideal gas, Z is equal to 1. And for real gas, Z is not equal to 1. Z is not equal to 1. Okay. Now if get Z less than 1, it means that the gas is less compressible than expected from the gas is less compressible. The gas is less compressible as expected from ideal gas behavior. The gas is less compressible means the gas cannot be liquefied easily. And that deviation is called negative deviation. Okay. Now, if Z greater than 1 means the gas is more compressible. Gas can be liquefied very easily. And this deviation is called positive deviation. So if Z greater than 1, then kya hota hai? The gas is if Z less than 1, the gas is more compressible. The gas is more compressible. And if the gas is less compressible hoga. Okay. So if Z less than 1, the gas is more compressible, means the gas can be easily liquefied. Okay. But if Z greater than 1, the gas is less compressible as expected from ideal gas behavior. Okay. Now this plots of compressibility factor with respect to pressure for different gases. So now we are going to plot for compressibility factor with respect to pressure for different gases. Okay. So let us suppose this is a plot. Okay. This in the x-axis we have pressure. P, and in the y-axis we have compressibility factor. Compressibility factor that is Z. In the y-axis we have compressibility factor that is Z. Okay. So if this is the ideal gas line, here Z is equal to 1 for ideal gas. So we plot compressibility factor with respect to pressure for different gases like CO2, carbon dioxide, methane, CH4, then methane, then nitrogen, then hydrogen, then helium. Okay, and we've seen that this helium and hydrogen, these gases are less compressible, means these gases cannot be liquefied. These gases are less compressible, so it is showing positive deviation. So this is plot for hydrogen, this is plot for helium. Hydrogen and helium. So here Z is greater than equal to 1. Z is greater than equal to 1 means the gases, this gas is showing positive deviation, and this gas is less compressible. So this gas cannot be liquefied more easily. Okay. Now for gases like carbon dioxide, methane and nitrogen, these gases show negative deviations, means the gas is more compressible. So if this is the curve for nitrogen, this is the curve for methane, and this is the curve for carbon dioxide, this is the curve for methane, and this is the curve for carbon dioxide. So this is nitrogen, this is methane, and this is for carbon dioxide. Okay. So the gas is less than 1, means the gases are showing negative deviations. So this is 1.0, means Z equal to 1 for ideal gas, and this is, these are below, so this is minus 0.5, this is 0.5, suppose this is 0.5, this is 1.5, okay, this is 2.0. So if this way we have plot compressibility factor Z with respect to pressure for different gases like hydrogen, helium, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and methane. And we have seen that hydrogen and helium, they show positive deviation, means the gas is less compressible, means that these gases cannot be liquefied very easily. Whereas the gases like nitrogen, methane and carbon dioxide, these gases show negative deviation, means the gases can be liquefied easily. So these gases are more compressible. Now we have also seen effect of temperature. So let us see what is the effect of temperature. So the scientists, various scientists, they have also seen the effect of temperature, and they, what they have done, they have plotted PV versus P, PV versus P for nitrogen at different temperatures. Okay, so they have seen that, suppose this is temperature T1, this is temperature T2, this is temperature T3, this is temperature T4, this is temperature T4. Okay. So as we are going on increase, this is T4 greater than T3 greater than T2 greater than T1. As we are increasing the temperature, the dip in the curve is gradually decreasing. decreasing. Okay, so dip in the carb is gradually decreasing. So at higher temperature like T4, it is almost nil. It is almost nil. So means this means that the dip almost disappears and the carb remains horizontal for a large range of pressure. And this temperature nitrogen behaves ideally. Okay. And also always boils low. Means that at temperature T4, this temperature nitrogen becomes ideal. Okay. And it always boils low. So that temperature is called Boyle's temperature. That temperature is called Boyle's temperature. Okay. And at this temperature, the real gases behave like an ideal gas. Okay. So this is the plot for PV versus P at various temperatures for nitrogen gas. This is for nitrogen gas. Okay. Now, the scientists wonder why these gases are showing these deviations. What is the cause? What can be the cause for these deviations? And they have seen that they have come out with two important conclusions that in the kinetics, so next we are going to study cause of deviation. So what is this? What is the cause of this deviation? So they have seen that in the kinetic gas equation and also in the kinetic molecular theory of gases, these two postulates is totally false. Number one is a postulate kya matlab bola hai, the volume of gas is negligible. The volume of gas is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. Okay. So this is negligible. Okay. And the second postulate is there is no force of attraction. There is no force of attraction or repulsion between the gases. Force of attraction or repulsion among the gas molecules or repulsion among the gas molecules. Okay. So these two postulates are totally wrong. These two postulates are totally wrong. So this is the cause of deviation of gases from ideal behavior. So means that the volume, jo postulate bola gaya ki volume of gas is negligible as compared to total volume of the gas, nahi ye galat hai. The gases have volume, gas molecules have volume, and that is not at all negligible. And another postulate that there is no force of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecule, this postulate is also wrong. There is force of attraction and repulsion between gas molecules. So this deviation, this cause of deviation should be corrected, and that was corrected by, and that was, so now we are going to see correction for deviations. Okay. So correction for deviations, and this was done by J.D. Vandervoels in 1873. He has done this correction, and he has said that this equation PV equal to nRT is no longer valid. So this equation should be P plus N square A by V square into V minus NV is equal to nRT for N mole for animals, okay, and p plus a by b square into b minus b is equal to rt for one mole of gas, okay. So this correction he has done in the year 1873, for which definitely he was awarded Nobel Prize. So he has said that this equation PV equal to nRT is no longer valid. So there is force of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecules. So the P becomes P plus A square A by B square, and the volume of gas molecule is not negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. So उसके लिए V नहीं होगा, V minus NV is equal to nRT. So this equation is called van der Waals equation, okay. And where this constant A and B, this constant A and B are called, this constant A and B are constants, okay. Where A is a constant for molecular attraction, okay, and it is called attraction coefficient, okay, and B is a constant for molecular volume, okay, and which is called co-volume or excluded volume, okay. So this is the van der Waals equation of state. This equation is called van der Waals equation of state, okay. So this equation is called van der Waals equation of state, okay. So this is called van der Waals p plus m square a by b square, v minus nv is equal to nRT. So now we will derive van der Waals equation, okay. So next is derivation of van der Waals equation that we will study in our next class, okay, and some conditions we have to satisfy, and this we will study in our next class, and probably in my next class I will provide you the notes also, my dear students. So with this I want to end up my session here today. So this is van der Waals equation, derivation of van der Waals equation we will do in my next class, and there are some conditions which we will do, and also molecular speeds also, and with this we will end our chapter, and at the end of chapter I will provide you the notes also. So the next portion is liquefaction of gases and liquid state of matter, which is totally clearly omitted from your syllabus due to this pandemic COVID-19 situation, okay. So with this I want to end my session here today. Thank you very much, my dear students, and study well, do well, stay safe, and all my best wishes from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.